Crunchyroll is at it again, and this time they're here to save the West with their very own hot take on anime. But Crunchyroll has had a history of brilliant choices that prove they're here for anime. Crunchyroll cares. Their previous offenses include their humble beginnings as a pirating site, only to hire a mentally ill manlet that berates anyone who talks about pirating anime on Twitter. Their censorship of mobile games, despite their core audience being extremely unhappy, going as far as to tell them they should just learn Japanese if they want to play uncensored. And holding narcissistic LGBTQ panels at conventions that have nothing to do with anime itself, and instead focus on self-absorbed frauds who think their lived experience is worth a damn to anyone, all while blocking anyone who dares question their motivation behind such a thing. But let's get into their recent business decision, a little project called High Guardian Spice, a Crunchyroll original, an anime streaming service offering an original. What could possibly go wrong? Oh, that's not anime at all. Well, surely Crunchyroll wants to hear what the fans think of this wonderful idea. Oh, would you look at that? Comments disabled. It's almost like they know it isn't going to be well received by people who actually want to watch anime. You know, their core user base and the whole reason their service is supposed to exist.
It's a very modern reflection of the world. Our characters are really diverse, our cast is really diverse.
Because there aren't enough anime with diverse casts, or casts that are primarily made up of women, or even created by women. It's not as though some women are among the most wealthy mangaka in the world or anything. Now, who do you think is behind something like this? Wait for it. Wait for it. Well, I'll be a pronoun in a furry's Twitter bio. Imagine my shock. Who would have guessed people straight out of the progressive factory would be behind this? You know, they say you're not supposed to judge based on appearances, but these gargantuan fee-whales with thick-rimmed glasses and bright-colored hair are proof that stereotypes exist for a reason. Clearly, Crunchyroll has decided to invest in Tumblr Studios for their latest project.
And that's one of the things that excited me the most about it.
People are really excited about what the show is and what it represents.
Of course, who isn't excited about the death of the quality of animation? These people are all the same. They leech off the backs of the successes of others in an attempt to infiltrate and co-opt, because without doing so, no one would ever pay attention to anything they create, because it's as lifeless and soulless as they are.
High Guardian Spice is about four girls who live in a magical city and are going to school to become guardians.
We are 50% female in all the creative roles, and our writer's room is 100% female.
You know that a show is going to be great when the trailer tells you nothing about it other than a vague premise, while driving into your skull over and over that it's made by a very diverse group who all just so happen to be women. No contradictions there. Well, maybe some of them are multi-system otherkin with non-binary polyamorous headmates, because nothing says diversity quite like focusing on a single group.
I mean, this is what my whole career has been about, is trying to get those voices in there that are not being heard.
So what you have here is a studio run by a woman whose whole career has been about discriminating against anyone who isn't a woman, due to an imaginary lack of female voices that we've heard parroted in every field except the jobs feminists don't want whenever they want to excuse their bias. Very progressive. Very diverse. So much tolerance. You can't force an audience no matter how hard you try. If your show isn't any good, it will flop no matter how many buzzwords are used to dress it up. Crunchyroll, just like many others, is another company who prioritizes ideological narratives over the quality of the service they're actually supposed to provide, and they've shown a disdain for customers who won't kowtow to the narrative. Diversity is nothing more than a term used to manipulate you into believing that, simply by extension of consuming a product, that you're somehow doing something far more valuable than it actually is. You're watching a cartoon. That doesn't make you a hero or a champion of women the world over. They want you to believe that women are poor creatures that need your help because they are purposely cast aside on the basis of nothing more than the fact that they're women. Have they even bothered to look at this crap they're spewing out and passing off as quality? If this is the best women have to offer, maybe that's why no one cares.